They won't recognize me if I don't expose it. Yeah. No, there's no tit. There's no tit. It's just abs. This is what a real man looks like,
guys. Give the ladies what they want.
This is.
Give the ladies what they want.
When you think of body shaming, people typically go towards either she's too fat, she's too thin, but what we don't think about is women having muscles. That in itself gets body shamed all the time. They'll say, you're trying to be a man, why do you want to? I get body shamed for looking like this, and my wife tells me all the time that I'm small.
People tend to think that you're a lesbian because you're more masculine and fit.
They think I'm a lesbian because I love boobs.
Kind of say that people assume that you have to be attracted to women in order to be fit.
100%.
I think people assume that the more, quote, masculine you are, even though looking fit isn't masculine at all, in my opinion, but it's associated with masculinity.
Yeah, yeah.
You would assume that that person would like women.
And also that within my own same-sex relationship, I'm the top. It just so happens that this is my sport. It's got nothing to do with my personality or me being a top.
So you are a top.
I'm not. I'm a versatile power bottom.
Yeah, it's
if Katie wants to, that's
same.
It's yeah,
same
have at it.
Same.
Bothers me that people associate being strong with masculinity. I mean, there's a joke all the time that, you know, you can kick a guy in the balls and he's keeled over, but you can kick a vagina and nothing happens. Like, don't be a pussy isn't a thing. You want to be a pussy. It's hard as a rock. Started my first diet. It got really bad when I saw my first bodybuilding magazine. I actually wanted to look like the guy and not the thin girl with no muscle. To me, it wasn't about being thin. It was about being rock solid. You get into the vortex that is anorexia and you've killed all estrogen production in your body. You have no choice but to have more testosterone. When I was about 19, so I was just starting to think about getting better. I'd lost my dad. It was time. And she said something about like watching me sleep. Well, that's the creepiest thing I've ever heard. And she said, no, you don't understand. Your body was so little. I had to make sure the covers were still going up and down. And I said, wow, so this isn't just affecting my life, but it has been affecting yours since I was 11. I said, I cannot do that to you anymore. If I didn't get better by my 21st birthday, I would have had anorexia longer than I would not have had it.
Holy shit.
Right, and that's a sobering thought. But to an extent, we all have a body type, right? Yours is thin. You have to run with what your body naturally wants to do. What's become my target demographic is women with emotional eating issues or eating disorders. I realize that that is an oft neglected market, mostly because a lot of personal trainers don't want to deal with the psychology. As someone who's already been through it, that's all I want to deal with because I know how important and how relevant your relationship with food ties into your body image.
You offer a ton of these services from your Instagram page with people.
100%. I even have different tiers based on how much you want to communicate. If you just want a straight plan and checking in with me once a week, that's totally fine. There's a period of time where I didn't eat. There's also a period of time where I ate too much. There's nothing I cannot relate to on the spectrum of emotional eating or eating disorder issues.